In this tutorial, I'm going to teach you how to create your very own game passes. And not only use the game passes, but you can also basically purchase them through Roblox Studio and see if we can also add any gear or tools to our game passes as well. So the first thing I want to do is I want to create a button that allows the players to, when they want to buy something, they just click the button and something will come up showing that, hey, if you want to buy a certain pass with this special tool, you can. So I'm going to click on Start GUI and click Screen GUI because I want my Screen GUI to display a text button. I'm going to move my text button to the lower right side, and next thing I'm going to do is create a local script. In my local script, I'm going to delete print hello world, and the next thing I'm going to do is I am going to type out just a couple of lines of code to where not only do the players, when they click the button, will they have the game pass in possession, but we will also print out a message in our output window that says, hey, the game pass is in the player's possession. I'm gonna keep this other side basically blank because I want to show you what you need to do in order for you to use the button for your game pass. I'm also going to leave this area blank because I also need the ID number. All right. Now, we need to basically create game class in Roblox.com, so I'll show you that next step. So, I forgot one more step. Hold on one second. What we need to do before we create game class is we need to publish it to Roblox. Basically, go to File, Publish to Roblox, or Publish to Roblox As. And since I've already got my game pass here, just, you know, go through the steps just to override it. And there you go. My game's already been published. So let me just clear this output window. Now also, go to your home menu and go to game settings. And just go to permissions and make sure that it's set to public. So you can add your game passes. Now, once you have made your game public, you just go to your profile, go to creations, and select your game. Now, as you can see, right below here where it shows store, I already have a game pass already set up. Now, if you need to set up a game pass, you just click right here on add pass, and it's gonna take you to the develop page. Now, as you can see, I got two different game passes. The way you can create a game pass is you need to find an image that you want, rename the game pass to what you want, and put something in the description of what the game pass does. Then afterwards, it's gonna let you preview it. Now, if you can't see your image, that's okay. Just verify the upload, and also make sure that from select from public games, you select the right game for your Game Pass, or else it will show up in a different game area. Now, of course, that I already got my Game Pass right here, which is Cash Pass, so I don't need to do anything else. But I just want to see how it works. So I just click on my Game Pass, and what I need is basically the 8 digits right here. This is basically the ID number for the Cash Pass. And what this is going to do is when we click the button in Roblox Studio, it is going to show up a message saying, "Do you want to buy this Cash Pass?" So I'm going to return to Roblox Studio, and we'll go back to my local script. And I'm gonna paste in my my numbers. I'm gonna clear my output window, and I'm gonna run it to see if it works. Click my button, and there you see that it says, "Do you want to buy product Cash Pass for 1 Robux? This is a test purchase. Your account will not be charged." So I'll just go ahead and say buy now, and there you go. My purchase was successful. And this also says this was a test purchase. Now, something else didn't happen. It says local, if this is in my possession, it's supposed to print out a message. So let me go ahead and just correct this issue, see if something works, or thought it would print out a message, but if it didn't, that's fine. Basically, I was just testing to see if it did print out a message if I have my Game Pass in possession. So I can basically do other things with my my Game Pass. For instance, let's go and to my homepage. I'm gonna go to Toolbox, and I'm gonna try to find something like a weapon or something. Now, there's tons of weapons here, but I don't want to use anything that's a little bit, you know, graphic for you guys. But let's just use a turbo fusion ray gun. And if it shows up, put this tool in the start pack, just press no. Now I'm gonna take this ray gun and I'm gonna put it into replicated storage. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to type inside where it says Game Pass in possession. I'm going to type local, and I'll put raygun equals game get service, and then replicated storage, and then wait for child raygun. And then I'm gonna clone it to my player's backpack. So basically, raygun dot parent will equal to player dot backpack. So I'm gonna basically play the game again. By now, should be in the character's backpack now, but it shows that this is only a test purchase. So unfortunately, it says I took away the option for my character to basically have this in his inventory. Here's the deal. Here's what I can do. I can go back to basically Roblox, and I can just add another pass. And basically what I can do is copy the new 8 digits and put it to here, and then I can just see if it allows me to have my ray. Okay, so now I've already added a ray gun, and it says that this item is in my inventory. So I'm going to basically get the 8 digits for the ray gun, and I'm gonna paste it into my script, basically. right, so now when I play it, hopefully it will show up in my backpack, and it does. So basically we have the ray gun, and if I click button, it says you already own this item, your account has not been charged. So we now know that if we already have a if we already have our own game pass, it will show basically an item, or basically it will also show you if you have any cash or any currency, health, anything like that in your possession as well. Now I'm gonna also test this one more time, because I want to use the print method too. Basically print game pass in player's possession. I want to see if this works too. And it does. So basically game pass in player's possession, and we see the ray gun. So yeah, everything is looking good for our character. So that is basically one way of how you can use game passes for Roblox games. So thank you guys for watching.
Be sure to join Tech Dev Academy's workshops and camps, and also read some great articles on their blog page.